What's going on YouTube? I'm D. Ellis. I want to welcome y'all back to another episode of Crime Circuit. For this video, we're going to be talking about Melanie Carpenter. She was born April 22nd of 1971. Of course, this is educational purposes only. Everything that I found is strictly on the internet. If you guys are sensitive to murder, things of that nature, suicide as well, I suggest you click out of this video and hopefully I will see you in another one. So, with all that out of the way, make sure you guys like, share, comment, and subscribe. Alright, let's get into the intro. Melanie Carpenter was a Canadian 23-year-old woman who was abducted and murdered in British Columbia on January 6, 1995. Melanie was taken from her workplace in Surrey and found dead in the Fraser Canyon several weeks later. Now, the prime suspect, Fernand Aguirre, he would go on and commit suicide before he could be arrested for the murder of Melanie Carpenter. Now, in her, on her disappearance on January 6th of 1995, the 23-year-old woman from Surrey, British Columbia, had received suspicious phone calls from a man fringing interest in a business deal. Now, check this out. Later that day, Carpenter would be abducted from where she worked at the tanning salon in Fleetwood Town Center of Surrey. Now, talking about her investigation, the afternoon that Carpenter went missing, a bank security camera recorded a 37-year-old man, who happened to be Fernand Aguirre, was making a $300 withdrawal using Carpenter's debit card, and the footage was shown on national TV the next day. Aguirre was a drifter from Ontario, frequently working as a waiter in restaurants, and had been a resident of Calgary, Alberta, until moving to BC days before the murder. In August of 94, Aguirre had been released from prison in Bowdoin, Alberta, where he had served a 16-month sentence for armed robbery, and he was on parole at that time. Aguirre quickly became the number one suspect in the abduction, and a warrant was issued for his arrest. Now, it would be on January 15th of 1995, a girl would be found dead at a vacant home in High River of Alberta, approximately 55 kilometers or 34 miles south of Calgary, by a real estate agent during the viewing of a client. Can you all imagine that? Y'all being a realtor and y'all going in and showing a house and there'd be a dead body. Man, that's crazy. Aguirre had committed suicide in a garage on the property by inhaling carbon monoxide fumes from the engine of his car, specifically a Hyundai Excel rented from Calgary. Carpenter's corpse was found shortly afterwards along an isolated road in a First Nations reserve near Hope, a rural town in British Columbia's Fraser Canyon, 45 kilometers approximately 28 miles northeast of Chilliwack. Carpenter's body had been abandoned in a crevice and concealed by a white blanket. Now, in 1995, the Melanie Carpenter Foundation was established to create a memorial for Carpenter. After her death, Carpenter's father formed a petition to keep murderers in prison as speeches were made. Petitions were signed and rallies were held in protest against Canada's parole system. Now, according to her father, Carpenter was afraid of being abducted. He said he advised her not to put up a struggle if attacked by a man with a weapon, that it was better not to resist and to stay alive. Since her abduction, though, he has cause to reconsider. I wish, he said, I had told her to fight with everything she's got. Carpenter loved her family and feared the attentions of men. She often told her mother, Mom, when you go out, hold your head up. Look like you're in control. Don't look vulnerable. Don't look like you could pray. Don't look like you could be prey. Man, it sounds like she was definitely on her P's and Q's. Carpenter worked alone at the Island Tan outlet, even though her boss, Gary Marshall, had tried to convince her to work at another location where there were usually two or more women at one time. I appreciate y'all for checking out this video. Make sure you guys like, share, comment, and subscribe. This is a tough one, man. I don't have a daughter, but I mean, I couldn't imagine anything happening to my kids or anything like that. But I like to say condolences to the family, of course. And for the man to off himself, you know, took the coward way out. But, you know, hopefully the family, you know, is able to heal from this. Of course, they will never fully recover from it, obviously, but hopefully they've by now found some sort of peace within themselves. But yeah, man, I appreciate y'all checking out my video. Make sure you like, share, comment, and subscribe. Peace.